I'm Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, owner of Bemint and specialized in Power Query. This is one of the videos in the series about global datetimes in Power Query. Power Query has no standard functionality to convert date and times between Windows time zones. If clocks are switched because of daylight saving time or because of government decisions, as a workaround, you can create a table with clock switches in Windows time zones. Combine these tables to have the data available you require to convert date and times between Windows time zones. For one time zone, such a table would look like this. I have the period 2015 through 2024. The table starts with midnight on the first date of the period, and then for each clock switch, there is an entry in the table. So you can see that on March 29, 2015, 1 a.m. UTC time, the clocks in the local time zone were switched from 2 a.m. to 3 a.m. In this video, I will explain how such a table can be created. First, you have to set your local time zone to the time zone required. In my case, that is the time zone for Amsterdam. Apologies for the Dutch screens, but my Windows is configured in Dutch. But I will explain and translate whenever required. If you have date time values in Power Query, then you can convert these values to a data type that is only available in Power Query. That is the date time time zone data type. And you can use the standard function date time at a zone to add a time zone to a date time value. This time I add the zone with a 0 offset hours and 0 offset minutes being the UTC date time zone. If I duplicate this column, I can just change the format back to date time. And then I get the local time on which the daylight saving time switches are taken into account. In this column, you can see the UTC offsets. They used to be 2 hours ahead of a UTC, but on October 29, the clocks are switched back at the end of daylight saving time. And now the UTC offset is only 1 hour in the standard time. So if you want to create a table for a long period of time, then you can generate dates for the entire period and use this process to determine the UTC offsets for each date. Find the dates where the UTC offset was changed. Then you can drill down into quarters of an hour and repeat the same process to find the exact time on which the clock was changed. This is done in Excel workbook Bemint Time Switches Local Time Zone. You can find the link below the video. In this query, all the data comes in pairs. So I have 2 columns for UTC, 2 columns for UTC date time zone and local times and offsets. The first column is for one date and the second column is for the previous date. So I can easily check if the offset was changed. And I keep all the records if it is the first record, and otherwise all the records where the offsets are different. This results in this list of date times on which the clocks were changed, or actually the date before. Now I can drill down into quarters of an hour by multiplying the date values by 96, which is the numbers of quarters of an hour in one day. And then I expand the table in some steps, resulting in all the date timestamps for each quarter of an hour of all the dates that were selected in the first stage. So I have January 1st, then I skip to March 29, and so on. And the difference between each pair of columns is a quarter of an hour this time. So I created a new set with pairs of columns and a keep column to keep the first row and otherwise all the rows where the offset was changed. If I select the records, then I get all the UTC date times on which the clocks were switched in the local time zone, the local after time, and this is the offset just before the switch. And this can be added to the UTC time at the time of the switch to get the local time before the switch. Removing and reordering columns gives me the final result. You can change this workbook with the name of the current time zone, and then you create another table for another time zone by leaving Excel. Change the time zone, for instance, to Lord Howe Island, and make sure you have this checkbox checked for automatic adjustment of the clock for daylight saving times. If I refresh the queries now, then I get all the clock switches for Lord Howe Island. Interesting is that the daylight saving time switch is only half an hour. And the daylight saving time starts in October and it ends in April, as Lord Howe Island is on the southern hemisphere. If I wouldn't check this box, then I wouldn't get any clock switches. After refreshing the queries, I have only one row left for the initial date and time value. There's one exception. If, for instance, I check time zone Chetumal, there is no checkbox to have the clock automatically adjusted to daylight saving time, because daylight saving time is not observed in this time zone anymore. But if I adjust the start date a little bit and refresh the queries, then you still see clock switches, because Chetumal used to observe daylight saving time until 2015, when the clocks were moved ahead with 1 hour and Chetumal switched to another time zone. So this is how such tables are created with the clock switches for one Windows time zone. If you create Excel files for all the Windows time zones you require, then you can combine these tables and use the resulting table to convert date times between those Windows time zones. I will explain the combined table in another video. So this is the end of this video. Thanks for watching, and see you again in the next video about global date times in Power Query.